Ministries. I'm your host today, Manafizikar. Greetings from Him which was, which is, and is to come, the Almighty, and from the seven spirits which are before His throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, who loved us and washed us in His own blood, and made us kings and priests unto God His Father. To Him be the glory and dominion forevermore. Amen. Welcome. Today's sermon is entitled, Let the Dead Bury the Dead, but you follow me. These words were expressed by our Lord unto a man when he came unto him. He said, follow me. And he said, Lord, I will follow you, but first let me go and bury my father. There is no time to turn back. Once the call comes onto you, there is no looking back. For our Lord said, he that put his hand to plow and look back is not worthy of the kingdom. Today the call goes out to you. Come and follow him, our Lord and Savior. Come and follow Jesus Christ. Come and follow Yeshua HaMashiach. For he is the life giver. He is the redeemer, the restorer. He will lead you in the paths of righteousness. You have many things behind you that you're ashamed of. But behold, in him, all things are made new. You will be created in righteousness, in holiness, for the praise of our God. And your works will be acceptable in His sight. Do not look to your friends to walk the way you're called to walk, because behold, they are dead in their sins. But to you, the call of salvation is sent forth, if you will hearken and follow him. Do not delay in accepting the call. Do not delay in pondering the call which is done by faith. By faith you will answer. By faith you will believe. By faith you are here. God will know all his works from the foundation of the world, as ordained for you to hear and believe and to be saved. The cause of the call could be your friends. The cause of the call could be your girlfriend, your partner. The cost of the call could be your mom, your father, your children. It might even require your life. The cost of the call is great, for the reward of the call is eternal. It's not temporal. It will never end. Our Lord, when he saw the promise that was set before him, he suffered death and was faithful. For he knew that the glory that was before him was not compared to the suffering that he will have to go through. But in the end, he knows it will be worth it. It being worth it, if you understand the call that's coming to you now, you will go and sell all that you have to lay hold of this promise. Sell your ungodly life. Sell your unbelief. Sell your adultery. Sell your immoral thoughts. Sell everything that is exalted in your life today. And repent and come to the true fountain of life. He that call you is the one that distributes the Holy Spirit. He will anoint you with the oil of joy and put upon you the Spirit of God, so that you'll be able to walk the call that is before you. He will make you fishers of men. He will restore to you the years that you have lost, and he will set before you a table fit for a king. He will make you a redeemed, chosen, sanctified child of God. His blood will cleanse you from every sin. The call goes out to you today. Are you willing to accept that call? Are you willing to lay it all down before him? Are you willing to give up that which is holding you back? Are you willing to rejoice in the goodness of God? For I declare before you today that God is calling you out of sin, out of darkness, into his marvelous light. And he's doing it because his love for you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whomsoever would believe in him will be saved. And his Son is saying to you, follow me. Follow me, and I will lead you in the paths of righteousness, in the paths of life, and I will let you know the true and eternal God, and I will be the way, the truth, and the life in your life. I will open the door before you that no one can shut, and I'll shut the door of your past, of your sins, that no one can open. I see your heart is dark, but I will give you a heart of light. There is nothing, absolutely nothing, I cannot change in your life. Thus saith the one, the Holy One of Israel. I came not for the righteous, but I came for sinners. I came to save you. It was for you I came, that you may live and not die. Follow me, and your joy no one will be able to take from you. Follow me, and you will see the truth of the Word of God. I do not call you unto uncleanness, but unto holiness. I am calling you because you're dying. Your sin is killing you. You're going to be condemned. But behold, my hand is stretched forth to you. Take hold of it and come. I will deliver you from this debt. I'll give you a second chance. Follow me. Do not follow after unrighteousness anymore. Don't let your friends call you back. Don't let sin disguise in a woman deceive you. Don't let unrighteousness or the love of money condemn you anymore. Forsake all that you have and follow me. For I have prepared a mansion for you. I prepared life and joy everlasting. You will not be the same if you follow me from this day. I promise to change your life, to wash away your sins. My blood will cleanse you, thus saith the Lord. His blood will cleanse you from every unrighteousness, from every sin. Follow after him, and he surely will redeem thee. I myself will speak to you, have been redeemed by him, and I know he's faithful and true. I know his word is life everlasting, for his word is the word of God. And if you lay hold on it by faith, today, this very day, your life will be transformed and the door of salvation is open before you. Follow him. He said, follow me. Follow me. Heed his call. Lay hold of his call. It's not an accident that you're here today. It's your time. It's your day. He heard your prayers in your time of need. And now he's come to set you free. Follow not your friends that go after unrighteousness, that delight in the things of this world. You're being called out of this world. You're being called into the heavenly, where you life shall be hid in Christ. I ask you to accept the call of our Lord. He is faithful. The journey before you will be a journey of joy. Even through trials, you shall see he is faithful. I know somebody will come. I know this message will not fall on deaf ears. For whatever God ordained, it shall spring forth and it shall bear fruits. And you are the fruits of this word. The kingdom of God is being increased today, for God has desired you to live. For he said in his word, I wish not the death of the wicked, but that they shall repent and turn and live. It's your turn to repent. It's your turn to live. Let us pray and receive our Lord, because this is why I'm here, for us to pray that you may live. For the Spirit of God is with you and he's about to transform your life where you are. He's watching. He's knocking at the door. Just open your heart and He's coming in. Let us pray. Thank you, righteous God, for sending your only begotten Son to deliver and to save this person. Thank you for adding them to your kingdom. Thank you for cleansing them through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. Thank you for restoring them unto the paths of life. Thank you for giving them another chance as they accept your word, O righteous Father. Deliver them from the kingdom of darkness. Let them see your marvelous light. Let them rejoice in your presence forevermore. Prepare before them, O righteous Father, the way of righteousness, and deliver them from the deceit of the enemy. Cause them to stand through every trial, and let them know your love and your mercy. Let them be sanctified by the blood of the Lamb, O Lord and Savior, and let them rejoice forevermore. O righteous Father, hear the words of their prayer, which they shall pray. Repeat after me. Jesus, I repent of my sins. I believe that God sent you to save me and stand in my place. You died on the cross that I may live. Sanctify me, cleanse me, and I will follow you all the days of my life. I hear your call. I am coming. Save me now, Jesus. Save me, I pray. I believe the word of God. Save me this day. I will follow you all of my life. Sanctify me and forgive me of my sins. Let me live and change my life. This I ask in your mighty name, thou Son of the Most High God. Help me, I pray. Amen. If you have prayed this prayer, we believe that you are on the road to the kingdom of God. We believe that Jesus will honor your prayer. We believe you will be sanctified and justified. Now, fight the fight of faith, wherein you are called unto holiness and righteousness. Temptations and trials will come your way, but cast your burden on the Lord, and He will deliver you and stand. We pray that God will cause His light to continually shine in your heart, and He will take away your stony heart and give you a heart made of flesh, that you may obey His word all of your days. I welcome you, and I'm glad that God is using Beza Ministries to touch lives across the world. Friends and family who you know need Jesus, share your testimony to them, and share this video also to those who you know are lost, that they may follow Him that do and send and save and His calling. Let them follow the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Lamb of the Most High God. This I pray, that you will obey the word and share and subscribe and do the things that is good in God's sight. Above all, live in holiness and righteousness from now on. And the Holy Spirit, which our Lord will give you, will lead you and teach you in all truths. This is Beitzav Ministries. I hope you keep in contact with us, and I hope you continue to grow in knowledge And if you cannot find a church, continue to watch BXR Ministries. Or if you're in the UK, we'll have service coming soon. We'll be having this weekly service. So if you want to get in contact, just contact or email via email, and contact via WhatsApp on our phone or landline. But whatever you do, we pray that you walk in holiness and righteousness. And remember, do not turn back, for you are called as a child of God. To Him be the glory, honor, and praise forevermore. Amen. Amen.